Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a reading for Scorpio. This is for Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and this is for 6 months from now. So we're going to get a couple of these. What do we have for Scorpio 6 months from now? Keep in mind that free will plays a part, and a lot can change in 6 months. So what do we have for Scorpio 6 months from now? Door and table. Opportunities are waiting for you. Open that door. Open that door. There's opportunities waiting for you. Hard work is ahead. So there's an opportunity waiting for you, and it's not going to be easy. Ain't that just wonderful? Let's get one more. One more for Scorpio. One more. One more, please. 6 months from now. Arrow. You're on the right path regarding some aspect of your life. You're on the right path. So, it looks to me as though there's a door that is closed right now. May open any time. It could open at any time in the next 6 months. It's just waiting for you to open it. That's what it is. You have to choose to do it. That's why it's hard work. So the thing is that when you go through that doorway, you will have made the right decision. So do not doubt it. Do not doubt it. So I think you're going to be presented with a new opportunity. And it does have to do with an actual door, like a door, like walking through a new door. And I think this is like a physical door. You're actually turning a handle. Now, I don't know if it's to a new job or a new place to live or, you know, a new home or something, a new car. You're actually opening a door of some sort, I believe. Okay, and this is going to lead to an opportunity that isn't going to be easy, but it's going to be the right option, whatever that is. So what do we have for Scorpio? 6 months from now. Hard work. Something. It's not going to be easy, whatever it is. Because, you know, if you go through a new door, it's usually not easy because it's unfamiliar. So there's something unfamiliar about it. So what do we have for Scorpio? Whew. Page of Swords reversed. Now the Page of Swords reversed is a message you don't want to hear. Ain't that just wonderful? Knight of Swords reversed. Now this is a runaway train. Okay, we got something. We got a problem. Right off the bat, we got a problem with both of these energies being in reversed. There could be some mental health issues. I don't know if you're dealing with somebody that has mental health issues or, you know, I don't know if you do. I've no offense or anything, but I read as it is. I'm not here to spare anybody's feelings, and that's the way it goes. You guys probably already know that by now if you've been watching me. But with both of these reversed, we could have somebody that has some mental issues. And it could be, I don't know who it is, but I'm sure that you do, okay? I'm sure that you do. It's pretty evident, okay? Somebody may be agitated or they're a liar, they have difficulties, they're hostile, they're aggressive, they're psychological, you know, they have psychological issues. It doesn't look good with these two things reversed. Somebody could be being led into danger or they've been led to a bad place by an air sign. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Doesn't have to be, but it's pretty prominent here. Okay. So we got somebody here that is maybe looking for a fight, does not want to be held accountable for any of their actions. This person blames everybody. So I don't know who you are dealing with, but and this is kind of in the past because I'm working my way over. So this is somebody that you may be dealing with this person right now as you're watching this reading, or you dealt with them in the past. This person may be malicious. They may be saying stuff about you, you know, to bring you down. This is a troublemaker. You may be dealing with a troublemaker. And this person, and honestly, I feel like you're dealing with somebody that has mental health issues. I don't think it's you. I mean, I don't know. It could be. I mean, a lot of cross watchers are, and these readings can go vice versa. So I don't know. Justice. I don't know if you are dealing with a Libra, but you absolutely could be. Oh my God. So the way it goes is right around the corner. This is right around the corner. Past into what is about to happen. So we get the tower, blow up, explosion, okay? That's what's going to happen, okay? So this is a disruption. This is light being shed. But when the tower comes, it sheds light on a situation that you needed to see. You needed to see this. You needed to see that something wasn't stable or somebody wasn't stable. You needed to see it. So that's why the tower fell. It had to happen, okay? After the tower comes the star card. So, you know, if you haven't, it looks as though there's light that is going to be shed on a situation and it is going to force you to see something, okay? It's going to, and now this, the Justice is a card of a final decision. It is a card of integrity. It's a card of truth and something being fair and just. And this is karma. So I'm wondering if there's going to be some karma that is delivered. And this is a shock. Okay, so there could be some shocking decision that is made, okay, because this is a shock. So somebody has been acting recklessly. They may have some mental health issues. Maybe they get sent to the mental hospital or something like that, or the mental ward or something like that, or to rehab or to jail, or the law steps in. I'm just saying, we have some really reckless behavior here. Okay, and this is the law, and this could be the laws of karma, or it could be, you know, the physical law, whatever you want to call it, the justice system. But whatever is going to happen, it's going to be shocking. Okay, and this is news. So this is, you know, the Page of Swords in reverse is news or a message that you don't want to hear, but it could be the other person that is receiving the message. There could be news of legalities, put it that way. I do believe we have somebody in your reading that, or that is around you or in this reading right here that has some mental health issues, okay? I don't know who it is. Let's get the rest of the cards before we go any further. I'm not sure if you're dealing with a Capricorn. Could be dealing with a Capricorn, could be dealing with a Libra, could be dealing with another Scorpio. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius is very prominent. Aquarius and Libra or Capricorn. Let's just get the rest of the cards. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And all out war. Very hostile situation. I am very sorry. I'm sorry, Scorpio. Looks as though you are going to, you may be in a state of confusion. You may be needing to make a choice, needing to make a better choice. This is a card of consequences. You know, choose wisely. What you own owns you. You're going to be presented with an option 6 months from now, a choice of some sort. Now, this has to do with the toxic bond. You may be dealing with somebody that is toxic, somebody that is unhealthy. This person may have addictions. This person may be obsessed. I don't know if it's you or the other person. We have an obsession here. Somebody that is bound. They are bound and they're not seeing that it is unhealthy. There's some sort of obsession. Now it's time to go. The Six of Swords. This is, somebody is going to have an angry outburst by the looks of things. They could get really mean. They could get really mean. Maybe they get drunk or they do something, you know, and it doesn't have to be drunk because we have addictions here. It could be drugs, whatever. There could be some sort of situation that comes, you know, suddenly. There could be a sudden explosion, put it that way, or a sudden illumination. I don't usually see this with the, it's almost like I feel like it's like I can't think. It's right there too. It's like that something is about to explode and it's about to knock people right on their ass. It's like when the rocket goes off at Kennedy Space Center. A big, big boom, you know. It's like a, freaking no. I can't. It's there, but it's not. Anyway, you don't see it coming. You don't see it coming. Anyway, I think that somebody is obviously the Six of Swords moving to a better place. They've been stuck. There's been a lot of fighting. It is going to happen. This is what's going to happen. But the challenge is controlling anger. We have somebody here that is going to be having a hard time controlling their anger. Somebody's going to get really angry. Really angry. And I feel like it's because they're not getting what they want. And I feel like, I mean, when you get the Star card reversed is why. Why me? Why me? Why is this happening? Why is this happening? So there could be a depression. Somebody may be going through some sort of depression or having a loss of willpower or being, their faith may be being tested because they don't know what is happening. I feel like whatever is happening is does have to do with karma. It does have to do with justice. It has to do with the legal system. It has to do with the law. Somebody may have done something against the law here because this is very reckless behavior. So I feel like we have somebody that has done something against the law, and they may have been stalking. Stalking is against the law. Somebody may be stalking you, okay? Or you're stalking them. There is some sort of something going on, and it's because we got somebody here that's not satisfied. They're not happy. They're not happy that their wish did not get fulfilled. Okay, the Nine of Cups reversed and the Star card reversed. Somebody's wish didn't get fulfilled, and they are obsessed. They are obsessed. They are obsessed with that fantasy. The Seven of Cups is about fantasy. This is fantasy land right here. So we got somebody that is obsessed with something that is an illusion, and they can't let it go. They're bound to it. They're tied to it. They're tied to this fantasy, and they keep feeding this fantasy, maybe with drugs, maybe with alcohol, maybe with addictions, whatever. It's time. You got to break free. You've got to break free. And that's the sword that, you know, makes the final decision, that severs the ties. So I think that this month somebody may be severing ties. I do see something that is unhealthy. And we do have somebody here that is very tempted to leave, this competition. There's been a big competition. It's been a constant battle. There's been some sort of fighting going on, definitely. So I think we have somebody here that is going to lose it. I do think they're going to lose it. It's like there's going to be a breakdown. A mental breakdown. I think it's going to be a mental breakdown where somebody loses it. They lose their temper. They lose control. They just can't master their emotions. They blow up. Perhaps the law gets called. The you know, I don't know who it is, if it's the police or whoever it is. And, you know, I'm just saying, maybe they get put behind the door. I don't know. Let's see. I'm sorry. But this is a necessary evil. The tower is a necessary evil because there is something here that is unhealthy. And you must move on from it. But we have somebody here that is struggling. They are struggling, and they are struggling hard. It's time to end this conflict. It's time to bring peace. But if you keep... the devil is ruled by shadow. So if you keep on hiding the truth or not accepting the truth and being tied to something that is unhealthy, maybe it's just a bad habit. It could be a bad habit. It could be a bad addiction. It could be an obsession to another person. So we have somebody here that is obsessed with something that is not good for them. It's karmic. It's karma. There's a lesson to be learned here. So the tower comes in to blow this shit up, to force you to move on from it. So be prepared to move on from something that is not good for you. And you don't have to like me for delivering this message, but that is what this message is. And it is going to be hard work. Yes, it is. Whew. All right. Let's get a couple more cards here. Oh, Five of Swords. Damn. This is defeat. This is surrender. It's non-negotiable. We have a hostile situation here. We have somebody that has no morals and has no conscience. Now, I don't know if you're dealing with this person, but it's time to walk away. You're dealing with a master manipulator. So, and if it ain't, I mean, this can go vice versa. This is a pathological liar, somebody that does have mental health issues. We got somebody here does. this person abuses their power, isn't loyal in any way. It's like we're dealing with a freaking criminal here. This person has a personality disorder. They're delusional. Violent. We have violence here. I don't know if we're dealing with a narcissist. This person doesn't, whoever you're dealing with, whether it's you, however you guys want to take this, we have somebody here that does not care who they hurt. They are very selfish and self-centered. They are only in it for instant gratification, and that is it. It's a false sense of security. It's a false foundation. So I feel in 6 months from now, you are going to be experiencing, I mean, you think about the tower. I'm sorry that this is going to be going on 6 months from now, but I can't, I'm not going to say, oh, the tower can sometimes be good. The tower is not easy. It's not. That's a fact. A tower is not easy. It's hard work. Something has to be broken down. And when something breaks down, it's not pretty. But there is a good aspect out of it, because it forces you to take a new approach and go to a better place. And I do feel like somebody is going to a better place. They are being taken to another place. Somebody, you know, what I just saw. This is crazy shit. This is old, okay? I just saw like Alcatraz, you know, how they have to drive the, they had to bring the people over to the prison, you know, or whatever it was. Yeah, it was a prison. But anyway, so I feel like we have somebody here that is being taken away and they're going someplace to deal with, I don't know if it's their addictions or whatever it is, being driven away. Or somebody could be going away, you know, they're walking away. That somebody is being walking away from a master manipulator, somebody who belittles them and does not respect them for even a second. So I do believe there is going to be a massive life change, because that is what the tower is. It's a massive life change that needs to happen. It needs to happen so that you can start with a clean slate. So that's the positive in the tower. Once it crumbles, you have no choice but to start over. So be prepared to start with a clean slate in 6 months from now. And I'm not trying to scare anybody, but I'm not going to sit here and lie. Good luck.